Correct.
Is that correct, guys?
No.
Jadi benarnya apa?
Because in the last sentence there is a saying that they become national heroes. So it means that everyone in that country have known them.
Okay, that's correct. Jadi dia bilang di sini over time, however, right, these figures have become national heroes. National heroes, it means satu negara itu mengenal dia, kan ya? Okay, that's correct. That's good, guys. Okay, next one. Kita lihat di exercise page 64. Bisa lihat ini enggak?
Kecil banget
ya. Kalau enggak, lihat di buku halaman. Okay, 64 yang di ini deh. Lihat yang di PowerPoint yang saya kirim. Udah pada lihat?
Udah, Miss.
Di PowerPoint ya, Miss, ya?
Ya, di PowerPoint juga ada itu yang saya kirim ke grup.
Oke.
Okay. Oke, coba Mbak Bella exercise 2.
Ya, Miss.
Exercise 2 on number 1.
Okay.
Yes.
Your cousin claimed to be late because there was a complaint. Even though I have my doubts, the explanation is plausible. It is complaint weeks. I'll just have to take his word for it. If a statement is plausible.
Okay. What plausible means?
Plausible means is. It is believable enough to possibly be true.
Your cousin claimed to be late because there was a campaign. Even though I have my doubts, his explanation is plausible. It is campaign weeks. I'll just have to take his word for it. If a statement is plausible, the answer is
D.
It is believable enough to
possibly be true,
or you must always believe it, or it makes no sense, or you have to doubt it. The answer is D. D, right. Plausible itu reasonable atau masuk akal.
Oh.
Yes, plausible.
Berarti sama kayak itu ya, makes sense.
Yes, makes sense. Jadi yang jawaban yang nomor satu ini adalah D, it is believable, dapat dipercaya. Oke, okay, number two, Mbak Diana.
If you don't cut down your spending, you'll be broke in no time at all, which word is a synonym of cut time.
If you don't curtail your spending, you will be broke in no time at all. Which word is synonym of curtail? What is curtail? What curtail means? Apa curtail ini apa yo?
Broke apa? Reduce curtail.
Mengurangi?
Is it?
It means reduce.
Reduce?
I mean. Reduce?
Reduce?
Atau manage?
Reduce.
Dia lebih dekatnya yang kemana ini?
Lebih dekatnya sih ke manage.
If you don't curtail your spending, you will be broke in no time. Biasanya kita mengurangi spending kita atau memanage spending kita?
Manage kalian.
Kita memanage keuangan kita, tapi kita mengurangi pengeluaran kita, kan? Jadi jawabannya adalah?
Manage.
Ah, bukan. Listen, okay? Kita biasanya memanage keuangan, tapi kita mengurangi pengeluaran. Jadi jawabannya adalah
reduce,
right? Jawabannya reduce. Okay, number three, Mbak Dina.
Yes, number three. The world must ever talk about this military action. It has to be a clandestine operation in order to succeed. Which word is a synonym of clandestine?
Okay, apa itu kira-kira?
Secret. Because clandestine like secret.
Okay, bacaannya clandestine.
Clandestine.
Sorry. Yes, clandestine. So, no word must ever talk about this military action. It has to be a clandestine operation in order to succeed. Which word is synonym of clandestine?
Secret,
right? Itu sebenarnya secret. Jadi itu rahasia atau sembunyi atau diam-diam. Ya. Ini kenapa ya? Kita membicarakan tentang influence, kenapa kita sinonim semua ini? Wadaw! Okay, let's move on to the next page 6-8. Coba 6-8. Exercise 6.
Exercise 6?
Yes. Okay, dapat? Itu masih ada jari saya tuh, ha. Yang number one. Number one, coba Mbak Dina tadi udah ya, Mbak Eka Puspitasari. Both sides. Both sides.
What the election contest word win contest them this claim the Abraham Abman Wahid trying to so will of the orang nomor akhir supporter said make you trying to create effort or to people who did not make it for a president what the war but end up
kok suara mbaknya putus-putus ya?
Cari ingat kayaknya please.
Okay, I'm going to read it one more time. Both sides in the election contest were throwing accusations at each other. The Megawati supporters claimed that Abdurrahman Wahid was trying to thwart the will of the people. The Abdurrahman Wahid supporters say that Megawati was trying to create votes or assign choices to people who did not really cast votes for president. What does thwart mean? Kira-kira thwart ini apa?
Block,
tickle, help, or figure out?
Menggagalkan berarti memblok.
Menggagalkan atau menghalangi atau block ya. So the answer is C, block. Right, correct. Good. Next one, Mbak Jahro.
There is a fierce arguments raging and assistance to the
the end our concert. The time is running out. We are being asked to expedite the matter by getting our academic paper in as soon as possible. What does expedite mean?
Okay, there is a fierce argument raging that the and the assistants to the dean are concerned that time is running out. We are being asked to expedite the matter by getting our academic paper in as soon as possible. What does it mean by expedite?
Mempercepat,
melancarkan. Jadi ini jawabannya adalah
quicken.
A quicken. Very good. Wait a second. I need to charge my laptop before it dies. Okay, jawabannya adalah A ya, mempercepat atau quicken. Okay, the next one. Let's read one more. From exercise 7, Mbak Junita, number
1.
Okay.
Soalnya belum bisa buka ininya, model digitalnya.
Oh, okay.
Exercise 7 or 6, ma'am?
Exercise 7, number 1. Exercise 7, number 1. Exercise 7, number 1. Sudah dapat?
Ini PCR nomor
8 ya? Yes, 6869.
Terlalu nggak jaringan.
Coba Mbak Junita bakalan nomor 2. Sekarang Mbak ini deh, Mbak Kurniawati nomor 1.
Nomor belum, Miss, ya?
Udah dapat, Mbak?
Boleh aku nyoba?
Oke, nomor 1 berarti, Mbak. If you count.
Saya, ya?
Yes, Mbak Junita. Udah dapat belum?
Oke, udah.
Oke, nomor
2, kan?
Nomor 1.
Nomor 1. Nah, tadi udah bukan nomor 1?
Belum.
Yang buat saya sih itu kan?
Yes, exercise 7.
Count all the letters.
Okay. Both sides in
the No. Exercise 7.
Exercise 7, if you count all the votes, you
yang
can
only yang nomor 1 if you
yes.
Yang itu ya?
Yes.
Okay. If you can all the vote in an area that have several candidate A and only some of the voted put in an area that have support candidate B. You skip the result in favor of candidate A. What does he mean? My answer.
Okay, let me read it one more time. Wait a second.
Selain.
Sis land. Okay, wait a second. If you count all the votes in one in an area that heavily supports candidate A, and only some of the votes in an area that heavily supports candidate B, you will skew the result in favor of candidate A. What does skew means? What does skew means?
Condong.
Nah, itu condong. Jadi kira-kira itu dia itu lebih ke mana nih jawabannya?
Slant.
Apa? Slant ini artinya apa? Slant.
Miring.
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 Miring, condong. Sama juga artinya ya. Alright, so the answer is B. C. Slant. Okay, number 2 Mbak Kurniawati.
Yes.
Number 2 Mbak.
To work time, don't make a right. And killing children is never legitimate, no matter what. But that's legitimate. Me.
Okay. To work crimes don't make a right. And killing children is never legitimate, no matter what. What does legitimate means?
Real.
Real? Is it real? Legitimate itu sendiri artinya apa?
Sah
atau benar adanya kan? Atau logis. Jadi itu adalah
right.
Sebenarnya ini lebih ke right.
Real or right?
Jawabannya di sini dibuat real, tapi menurut saya ini right. Karena itu right. Tidak benar gitu, tidak sah. Two war crimes don't make a right, and killing children is never real or is never right. Membunuh anak-anak itu nggak bakalan pernah nyata atau nggak bakalan pernah benar. Menurut kalian ini apa? Kira-kira ini jawabannya apa? Real or right?
Right.
Benar juga. Lebih spesifik ke itu ya, Michelle. Right?
Yes. I agree to right.
Real.
Never. Is never legitimate. Menurut saya sih lebih ke right, bukan real. Jadi killing children itu never legitimate, never be right. Because killing is not right, it's not real, it's not right. Right? Jadi saya lebih ke B daripada C. That's it for this one inference. Nah, di sini kita tadinya itu cuma yang saya kasih yang ada ininya. Apa itu namanya? Inference, draw conclusion. Yang di buku ini kita hanya melihat sinonim dari kata-kata tersebut yang mana enggak membantu sebenarnya. Membantu tapi sedikit dalam hal yang sedikit. Alright. Ada pertanyaan tentang inferences? Atau nanti saya kasih latihan tentang inferences. Jadi kalian bisa latih sendiri di rumah. Okay?
Okay.
Number, and then the next one that we are going to talk about, it's about inference juga, tapi di sini inference-nya tentang affixation. Pernah mendengar tentang affix enggak? Di dalam bahasa Indonesia itu afiksasi. Afiksasi. No, affixation. Yang mana kata dasarnya itu adalah affix. That's how we read it, affix. Affix is an addition to the base form or stem of a word in order to modify its meaning or create a new word. Jadi affix signal miss kata Mbak Eka. Oke, Mbak. Affix ini adalah penambahan ke, you know, base form, bentuk dasar, kata dasar. Penambahan di kata dasar di sebuah, pada sebuah kata yang mana untuk memodifikasi artinya atau membuat arti yang baru. Nah, afix ini dalam bahasa Indonesia juga berarti afix atau imbuhan. Tahu lah ini ya, imbuhan awalan atau akhiran. Tahu nggak? Pernah dengar ini nggak? Right. So, what is affixation actually? What is affixation?
Proses menambahkan kata gitu untuk menciptakan perbedaan form atau juga sebuah kata baru dengan arti yang lain.
Okay, how do you say that in English? Can you try?
Affixation is the process of adding a morpheme or affix to a word to create either a different form of that word or a new word with a different meaning.
Right, that's correct, Mbak. Very good. Okay, and then let's see here. In English grammar or morphology, do you know morphology? Morphology itu adalah ilmu, di dalam ilmu ini ya, ilmu bahasa yang membahas tentang bagaimana suatu kata terbentuk. Affixation is the process of adding a morpheme or affix to a word to create either a different form of that word or a new word with different meaning. Affixation is the most common way of making new words in English. Jadi kayak tadi mbaknya bilang itu, afiksasi itu adalah proses penambahan morpheme atau afix atau imbuhan pada suatu kata untuk membuat kata yang baru atau membuat kata baru dengan arti yang berbeda. Dan afiksasi ini sendiri adalah yang cara yang paling common biasa, bukan umum, yes. Afiksasi ini adalah cara yang umum untuk membuat kata baru di dalam bahasa Inggris. Contohnya tadi, kita ada dengar quicken, ya enggak? Mempercepat, quicken. Nah, quick itu sendiri sebenarnya, quick itu kata sifat atau kata benda atau kata kerja atau apa? Kata sifat. Quicken. Quick, kata sifat. Nah, kita menambahkan en di belakangnya, jadi dia kata baru. Quicken. Jadinya dia itu jadi verb. Ya enggak? Jadi kata kerja kan dia mempercepat. That's how we make a new word. We create a new word in English just to add affix in one word. And that's it. We have a new word. Okay. And the two primary kinds of affixation are prefixation, the addition of a prefix, and suffixation, the addition of suffix, while cluster of affixes can be used to form a complex word. Nah, ada dua jenis afiksasi yang sangat terkenal atau yang lebih dikenal atau yang sering dipakai dalam bahasa, yaitu prefix, awal, dan suffix, akhiran. Awalan dan akhiran. Tapi yang mana cluster of affixes? It means penggabungan dari prefix dan affix ini dapat digunakan juga untuk membuat kata yang lebih kompleks, yang lebih susah lagi, yang lebih kompleks lagi. Jadi nggak cuma akhir, nggak cuma awal, tapi dia ada awalan dan akhiran. So far, so good?
Yes.
Right, very good. Okay, nah di prefix ini kita juga bisa melihat beberapa contoh. Prefix, artinya tadi awal atau akhir?
Awal.
Awal.
Okay, awal. Kita lihat itu yang di screen ada anti. Coba dibaca dulu, Mbak. Tadi sampai siapa ya? Tadi sampai siapa? Mbak Junita ya? Mbak Kurniawati. Coba Mbak Rina. Mbak Rina coba.
Predict, meaning example, and entire, meaning.
Gak usah again. Dibaca yang meaning example-nya, Mbak. Coba langsung dibaca entire, against, supposed.
Oh, entire, against, opposed to, choose, entire, government. Anti-racist, anti-war, auto, self,
auto, yes,
auto, self, autobiography, this reverse or remove,
yes,
disagree, displeasure, disqualify.
Disqualify. Yes.
Down, reduce or lower. Downgrade. Downhearted. And then pre, before, pre-war, pre-wedding. Hyper. Hyper extreme, hyperactive,
hypertension,
ill, in, ear, not illegal. Impossible, insecure, irregular, miss, incorrectly, badly, misspelled.
And misspell. Okay, the last one.
Non-treatment, non-smoking. Over, too much, overcook, overcharge, overrate.
Right. Nah, jadi di sini ada prefix awalan, ada auto atau anti, ada this, down, pray. Pre, hyper, ill, im, in. Yang mana yang biasanya kalian dengar dari sini?
Auto.
Auto apa, Pak? Mbak?
Autobiography.
Kita sering bicara, mendengar ini ya. Coba ada apa lagi?
Hyperactive.
Anaknya hyperaktif sekali ya, gitu kan? Apalagi, Mbak?
Over.
Yes. It's overcooked. Masakannya it's too much. It's overcooked. Okay. Okay, Mbak Feby. Mbak Feby says, okay, I forgot to set my alarm. Wow, Mbak. Kelas kita 30 menit lagi selesai. Okay. Non-smoking. This is a non-smoking area, right? Okay. And then what else? How about impossible?
The most common is three, because for someone who likes shopping, we often heard pre-order.
Yang mana tadi, Mbak? Yang common yang Mbak?
Yang pre-nya.
Pre-order, ya. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Pre-order, right? Pre-order or yes, pre-order, pre-wedding, apa lagi ya?
That's pre-order yang suka online.
Iya, yang suka kelihatan ya, Mbak ya.
Kelihatan nih,
Mbak. Kelihatan, kelihatan. Saya nggak ada ke situ. Saya bikinnya pre-wedding, kelihatan ya pre-wedding.
Oh, ya pre-wedding.